Hi guys, it's Vlada here, and today I have an unusual video for you. So it's not going to be a recipe, it's just going to be a video where I will share with you some strategies on how to relieve stress and anxiety and overcome burnout. Both my husband and I overcame burnout at some certain stages of our life, and we would like to share some strategies that helped us to relieve anxiety in our life. Because we see so many people who struggle from stress, who are affected by stress or anxiety, and who are trying to do something good in their life, and it makes their life very hard. That's why we wanted to create this video. Let's first think what stress is. Usually when we think about anxiety or burnout, we think about some certain situation at work, in our relationships or in our life, some circumstances from the outside world. Maybe it's a micromanaging boss, or maybe it's a conflict with coworkers, or maybe it's a deadline at school. But very often, if we stop and think about stress, very often it's our reaction to the outside circumstances, to something, to some events that are happening to us. And this is the way stress is usually the way how we react to these events. Yes, I agree that sometimes you might have something happening to your family and there is nothing you can change about it, but very often stress is self-created. Both my husband and I had to face anxiety and stress after we moved to Canada. It happened to us because we were trying to find a good place to live, trying to search for good jobs, and then we were trying to settle down in the new country. And that was definitely stressful, but at the same time, we created a lot of stress ourselves because we were trying to achieve more in a small amount of time. Last year, my husband had to deal with panic attacks and I had to deal with anxiety because I definitely was worried about him, about our life. We had to do something about our lives. Gradually, over the year, we came up with a few strategies that helped us to manage stress and to be better at coping with anxiety and burnout. So this is what I'm going to share with you today. And I hope the strategies will be helpful in your situation and will help you to relieve stress and to reduce anxiety wherever you are. So these techniques are very simple. You don't need to buy anything expensive. You don't need a spa or vacation getaway. So try them at home and see if it's going to work for you. So strategy number one that helped my husband and me the most is trying to find a way to become present. You need to slow down and pause for a second and think about what's causing stress in your life. Why you're so anxious? What is wrong with your situation? When you will do this pause, you will understand yourself better. You will understand whether the stress is self-created or it comes from the outside world, and whether you can change the circumstances or maybe change your attitude towards the circumstances. So there are all these different ways to become present. It can be a yoga practice, it can be meditation, it can be journaling, or just as simple as a walk in the park. So meditation is one of the things that helped my husband and me the most because it helped us to understand our own feelings and it helped us to understand that we put too much pressure on ourselves in a small period of time and we were trying to cope with a lot in a small period of time. If you're new to meditation, try an application which is called Headspace. They have 10 free meditations. They are 10 minutes meditations, if I'm not wrong. All these meditations, all these recordings were created by a former Buddhist monk, Andy Padikomb. He studied meditation for many years before he launched this project. I hope this will be helpful because it helped us a lot. Another way to become present is journaling or gratitude. Gratitude helps me to be positive and to look at the things that I already have and to be grateful for them before I move forward. To practice gratitude every morning and night, I use the 5-minute journal. I will put the link below for this journal. There I write all the things I'm grateful for and something that will make my day great, what I can do today, for example, to make my day better. This is a great way to be happier every day. Another way to become present is tasting or savoring something. When I have a moment when I need to take a pause, to slow down, I take my matcha latte and I go on my balcony and I sit on my balcony in an old armchair and I'm watching the road ahead while sipping my matcha and the trees ahead. And it helps me to relax and to focus on the present moment. So the thing is, matcha contains L-theanine, which is an amino acid that helps promote the state of relaxation, and it reduces anxiety, and it helps me to experience the state of calm alertness. You can also drink matcha before your meditation practice if you want to be awake during your meditation and if you want to be focused. The second thing that helped my husband and me to reduce anxiety and relieve stress was reducing the amount of sugar in our everyday diet. It might be surprising to you, but one of the biggest causes of stress is your blood sugar level. When we experience anxiety, our adrenal glands produce more hormone which is called cortisol. If your blood sugar changes too much or too often, for example, from a high carb breakfast, the adrenal gland will release too much cortisol to pull the sugar level back. And in this case, you would feel very stressed or anxious or angry or frustrated. If you have quite a stressful life at the moment, try to reduce the amount of sugar in your diet. Maybe you can follow a keto diet, for example, which is high in fats and will help you to stabilize your blood sugar level. Or reduce the amount of caffeine, because caffeine affects your adrenal glands very much. They start releasing more cortisol. If it's hard for you to stop drinking coffee, try to replace it with matcha green tea, for example, which will give you the energy for the entire day for up to 6 hours. Or try to drink decaffeinated tea if you feel too stressed or overwhelmed. By reducing sugar in your diet, you will also protect some good bacteria in your gut, which affects your mood and can help you to live a happier life. So a lot of serotonin is actually made in our gut, and that's why we might feel happy if there will be a balance between good bacteria and bad bacteria in our gut. The next strategy or tactic that can help you relieve stress is sleep 7 or 9 hours a day. I know it's very hard, but sleep deprivation affects our mood and it affects our memory and brain function. So you need to sleep 7-9 hours every single day. I know it might be hard to those who have kids, and it was the hardest thing for my husband and me to balance. We're still struggling with it from time to time. But we used to go to bed at 1 a.m. Right now, no matter how busy we are, at 10 p.m., we try to stop all our activities and go to do some stretching or some meditation and then go directly to bed, no matter how busy we are. And it helped us a lot and it tremendously affected our health in a positive way. The next strategy is spend more time in a good company of positive people. We know how negative people can easily bring us down, and we know how good friends can support us and can help us move forward. We are very lucky. When we moved to Canada, we met some great supportive people that helped us create and do the things we love and laugh at the same time and relax at the same time. And we're very thankful to our family who was supporting us along the way. And we hope you will find this group of good friends that will help you to overcome anxiety and stress, to whom you can call, tell about your situation, and maybe your friends can help you cope with it. So another thing I want to say that in our case, we had to reduce the amount of time we spend with people who are either negative or don't want to change their situation and they're only complaining about things, because we felt this negative energy. And by reducing the amount of time we spent with those people, we helped ourselves, and I think we helped those people because they maybe stopped complaining, at least to us. And the last strategy, but not the least one, is take good care of your own body. I know when we feel stressed and when we feel anxious, this is the last thing we want to think about, taking good care of ourselves. And this is exactly the first thing we need to do. My favorite way to relax after a tough day is to take a bath with some Epsom salts. These salts you can find basically in any drugstore, or to take a bath with lavender essential oil. Lavender smell helps you relax, it helps you sleep better, reduce headaches, for example, and even heal your skin. You can diffuse essential oils in your bedroom before you go to bed, or you can put your essential oil directly on your skin. You can rub them on your temples or on your neck. You can also put 15 drops of lavender essential oil in your bath before taking a bath. So this is a great way to relax after a long day. Another thing that my husband and me are trying to do regularly whenever we feel stressed or anxious is to take 30 minutes and go to the gym. Very often after the gym, we forget why we're so worried or stressed before and what was the cause of our stress. And we just keep doing the things we were doing before, but without anxiety. If you're trying to cope with anxiety or panic attacks, the good news, it's manageable. The bad news is that you have to do it yourself. And you have to implement these tactics, or at least a few of them, and try them for some certain period of time. Because unfortunately, nothing comes fast. You have to try them for at least some time to do, for example, meditation regularly, not once a week, but every single day to see the results. Try to implement one strategy a week and see how it goes, whether this strategy is good for you or not, and whether you will see some positive results. And I hope you will feel happier afterwards. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!